Hello, everyone, and welcome to Hucolo TV. This is Saturday, July 16th, 10 a.m. Eastern Time, and welcome to another Hucolo webinar. Valerie, could you introduce our guests?
I sure will, Mark. I just want to say a special thank you to Mark before we begin. He set the webinar up today and has done so much work behind the scenes that we owe him a really special thank you. So in the room today, we have Jay, Johannes, Jonna Lee, Wendy, Ray, Shin, Shirley, Stephanie, Zakalu, and myself, Valerie. And I would like to introduce you to Jim Charles. Here we go, Jim.
Good morning, everybody. It's nice to be here with you today. First off, I wanted to say a slight apology to Kim and Sabrina that there was a lot of communication errors, and I hope they'll be back with us and channeling real soon. But I wanted to just say I'm sorry there were some communication errors. They were supposed to channel today, but things got messed up. But in saying that, I also want to say thank you so much to Wendy, because she is stepping in, and she is a wonderful channel full of information, galactic languages, and things of that nature. And we love her so much. Her energy is so, so powerful. So I'm going to start the day with a short prayer, and then I'm going to hand it over to Wendy, unless there's any other announcements that anybody needs to make. If you want to do that.
I just wanted to announce, Jim. Hi, everybody. It's Wendy. I just wanted to announce about Jim and Max's Reiki classes. And tomorrow's class is the 1B, correct?
Yes.
And I'll be there, of course. I was part of the first one, and I'll be part of the second one tomorrow. So I just wanted to let everybody know too. If you're not aware that they are doing Reiki classes, in Galactic Reiki, and it's a wonderful, wonderful class. I just wanted to let everybody know that and to check it out if it's something that interests you.
Yeah, I've already done it myself, and it is a beautiful class.
Where's
you
the
won't
information
forget it.
Posted?
Yes, the information will be posted. And one more thing, Jim will be back next week to channel, so everyone knows.
Yes, I'll be back next week. And our Reiki class goes Eastern Standard Time from 11 a.m. till 3 p.m. It's a little unconventional. It's not all a Sui Reiki. It has Aquarian Fire. It has Galactic Reiki. It's a combination of all the things that work on Earth right now, but very soon the Aquarian Fire Reiki will be coming out, which is actually more powerful, and the Galactic Reiki will be included in that. So we are a lot of new exciting things about energy healing are coming up. So
well, that's wonderful. So if you've done the Reiki class before, join in this one because you'll learn some new things.
Yeah, it's actually, there's a lot more material in Reiki. This is the Reiki 1 class, the very first class, the introductory class. So it's the Reiki 1 class. So it is the first class you would need to move forward. And after it's done, then you get a certificate. After the class is over, and Max is in charge of those. So, but anyway, it's really a wonderful learning experience, and there's more information than I ever thought imaginable for Reiki 1 at this point. It seems to be expanding because so many people are energy healers. In fact, everybody, and to some extent, is an energy healer. It's just the degree of power that you have in your hands. But once you get the attunements, that power is ramped up and made stronger. So if you're interested in healing, this is a place to start. So having said that, I will open this morning's webinar with a prayer or a blessing, whatever.
Before that, could I squeak in one more announcement?
Sure, sure.
I just want to point out we have 12 or 13 people in the room, and for anybody watching live on YouTube, you can switch over to the Hangout link. We have room for 25 people today.
Oh, thank you. Yes, that's a wonderful update. Mark has been so kind as to employ the 25 people hangout. So join us right now because there is room for 25 people to be in the hangout. So if you're hearing this and are in a little bit of disbelief, just count how many are already on in here, and it's over 10. So we can accommodate a lot more people right now. Alrighty then. I will start off with a blessing or a prayer, whatever God would like us to do. And then I will hand it over to Wendy and have a wonderful webinar today. One moment, please.
Thank you, Jim. Every blessing.
Thank you. We thank you and praise you, Heavenly Father, for all the wonderful things that you do, for all the great things that we see in the world and in our lives. We ask that you continue to bless us and bring in all those positive things. Of course, we see third dimension as a negative place sometimes, but let us be able to work through that with the positivity because it makes it so much easier when we bring you into the picture. Help us not to forget to bring you into the picture. We just ask that you be with us today. We ask that you be with Wendy and with all those that are participating today, that you would light their paths, open their minds, bring in the wonderful information, the best information that there is to be brought in today, that the light languages will be very helpful to those that are listening today, because I know that a lot of them will be spoken today, and hopefully many will be interpreted. We thank you and praise you for the path that we're on, to move forward, to bring light to the world. I know there are so many different aspects of what's going on out there. Help us to bring in the most truthful and most positive aspect of that. Thank you so much for all that you do for us. Guard us and keep us, help us, and let us understand who we are as individuals so that we might grow. Thank you so much. In your name we pray, amen. And Wendy, it's your time to shine, and shine you will.
Thank you, Jim. That was beautiful, as always.
Thank you.
I'm only sorry you won't be here to do my interpretations.
Well, I'm going to stay here for a little while.
Yay. Excellent. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. I have an echo. And I'm not sure if it's me. Is that better? Okay. Hi, everybody. This is Wendy. Many of you know me as Wendy from Languages of Light on my YouTube channel. And most of you already know me, though, from here at Human Colony. This is where it all began for me, actually through Jim and Max and Sabrina and actually a lot of people in this room were here then. So I'm actually just kind of not sure where to start as far as talking about galactic languages. Maybe I'll start with just saying I began speaking them in a hangout here in Human Colony, listening to other people speak them. And as soon as I did, it was as if a light bulb went off inside of me, and my heart opened up, and everything came in. And it was as if I found something of a highest joy and the highest love that I've ever experienced. And so that would be where I would start. A lot of you in this room speak galactic languages, have already done it perhaps on your own. I'm meeting more and more people who this is something they've been doing all their lives, or they've heard of it before. It's also been called speaking in tongues, and for those of you in the religious area, so it's been going on for millennia. It's actually, these are our ET languages. These are languages from the angels, from God, from pretty much every realm. It seems to me, in my experience thus far, everything seems to speak a language. Everything. And the elements, the elementals, the Native Americans understood this. They understood that everything's connected. And they understood that you could talk to the sky and make it rain. They understood that you could talk to the fields and help them grow. They understood that sound healed. They understood that sound helped things grow, helped things happen, helped things manifest. That's what they knew. And they knew that no matter what they needed to connect to, they could connect to it through their heart, their thoughts, their intuition, their mind. And this was taught verbally. None of this is why we can't really find a lot of this stuff. And I think we can all agree that we've seen evidence of these languages from Sanskrit on. I think in a lot of us, I have always felt like I was part of that from the beginning, you know, the whole beginning scribe thing and being a part of, being a part of the beginning of spoken language, written language. And I don't even know how I even, you know, how do you even think something like that up? You know, it was just something that, it was like I felt it immediately. And then I started writing galactic languages. I wanted to grab my book again. I always forget my tablet. And a lot of us do that now, too. A lot of these galactic written languages are coming in, and it's all information. And I like that natural law is only spoken. I love that. And what I find is happening is we're activating each other. As we start speaking these languages, it's almost like we're finding our family. And I have had the experience both directions, people listening to me as well as me listening to other people, because that's how it started. I was listening to galactic languages on the Human Colony Hangouts as well as other YouTubers, although I have to say I was very surprised at how many people were already speaking it and how many people were already doing this out there on YouTube long ago, before I even came into it. So that surprised me a lot. One, that they were doing it, and one, that I was so unaware of it. I couldn't believe I was so unaware. But it just wasn't my time. It wasn't, you know, it wasn't my time for it to be activated or turned on. So now what I discovered is, all of a sudden, I felt the need to want to share it, and people were listening, and then it was so exciting, and it brought me such joy. And then I realized the more of us that hung out together, more of us would start speaking it. And then I started realizing that if I was speaking it with somebody, even one-on-one, they would start to speak it too. And so it's like all of a sudden you start to understand, okay, we really are like activating each other. We really are turning something on with this it's not something new. It's like something I forgot that I knew, something I already knew. It's like, how do you explain 1 minute not being able to realize you speak another language that you don't even really understand what you're saying, and we'll get into that too. But to then all of a sudden have it feel so fluent that you don't even know what hit you. It's like all of a sudden I'm just speaking it, and there have been people who have said, and not just one person, that have said they can actually see colors when people speak galactic languages, because it's such a high frequency. And if you understand how the plants speak, the trees speak, not only telepathically, but on a higher dimensional level, but they emit a sound that when you connect our own EEG machines to it, you can hear. And I love telling everybody about the plant concerts. Just Google it. It's awesome. You know, But the point is that everything has a frequency and a sound all the time, whether you're hearing it or not. And so our ancestors understood this, and I think we have come to understand, too, the power of the pyramids has been a lot about sound, sound healing, vibration, the ability to have sound affect matter. And we all know that's a fact. Our science has already discovered and proved that over and over. You can talk to plants and they change their physics. You can talk to, you can apply sound to water, an ice crystal, and it changes. We know what happens to things that we don't love, cherish, and take care of. They wither and die. Sound heals. Sound is from the beginning, and everything makes sound. All planets, the whole, all of, we know how planets make the ohm, and the, I mean, the sun is the ohm, and I don't know enough about those to be versed in it, but each sound, each thing has its own sound, and so we all, each of us, our unique signature frequency, all of us. So when each of us speaks a galactic language, it's like somebody, it's like we recognize that frequency within each other, and it's like we know it's family. Many of us who speak different languages know that some of them are easier than others for some of us to speak. I can't speak some of the same ones some of the other people do because it's not as comfortable to me, and maybe it's because it's not my family, it's not familiar to me. So I think right now we're all, those of us who are speaking it and being guided to share these languages are trying to break the, the preconceived notions that there's something evil about them or wrong about them, because there's nothing but love and God, and I mean, everything is, if we're connected to everything, everything's connected to everything. Therefore, it's all part of the all. But the point is that there's been people, because of preconceived notions through different avenues, that have led people to believe that there's something wrong with speaking it, or that there's something evil about it. And I have even been asked, well, how do you know what you're saying or bringing in? What I can say is I know it's of the highest, deepest level of love I've ever experienced. It's actually brought me to my knees, and as if you'd see, when people are just so in love with the bliss that they're feeling, and that wanting to just dance and sing, it's no different than that. And I'm finding that they're coming out in all these different ways, whether it's through, sometimes they'll identify themselves as a specific, like I can start to tell their signature frequencies as well. When they're sending information to me, I can tell if it's like a collective, or if maybe it's a specific dialect. I can start to tell. But that's all just from sharing with everybody else and trusting my instincts, trusting the information that's coming through. If they're telling me that it's the Yahyel or the Pleiadians or the emissaries of the light, I have to know that's true, because I am not making it up in my mind. It's not like I'm formulating it. It's just there, like a channel is to a channeler. So it's just another form of channeling information from the divine and from our ancestors, our spirit guides. If we can access anything at any time based on our job here, our highest joy, our path, not everybody wants to speak them either. Not everybody's interested in it. However, some people will just listen, even if they don't want to speak it, because they're guided to the information. It's almost like a bunch of multi-level layers of information. Sometimes it comes out in actual words, and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it's not even translatable, because it's not supposed to be. It's supposed to be heard and felt. It's almost like you can, sometimes people will listen to it, and it's almost like all your chakras will open, or you can just feel the healing energy. If I get an interpretation, I will try to speak it.
The mystery being a small special ever from England.
I'll try to speak it, and so I'm trying to the best of my ability not interpret, to not judge what's coming through, and just allow the information to come through as I feel it. So with that said, right now, is there any questions so far about what I've said or what I haven't said yet?
Actually, Omran had a good question over here on the side that I'm sure a few people who aren't aware of much to do with this would have. It says, does anyone know where the high energies are coming from here? It's not all among us. Or not, it's not all any one of us.
I just meant that I just felt an incredible high energy. It's just racing and racing, and it doesn't feel that it's all coming from among these people in here. I was just curious about who it was from, or if there's okay. Anyone who's vibrations. That I was just curious.
I understand what you're saying. Okay. And this is a very good question that Omran and I actually, Omran started speaking languages. I think, did you start speaking languages for the first time with me in that hangout that day?
Yeah. Okay. A few months ago.
Okay, you're right. And this is a perfect example. I'm glad he's here. Omran and I, we were just in a hangout, and I was speaking languages, and I started getting this feeling that I get when I, like he is now, where you feel this energy and you're not really sure exactly what it is or who it is, and you're trying to identify it. The best way I can say is trust your instincts. Ask. Always ask. If you don't ask, you're not going to know. Simply ask. Who is this that I'm feeling? I feel a love here. Welcome. Who are you? And almost always, you'll get at least a feeling. And the reason why we don't take it literally is because it's a feeling. It's not like we expect it sometimes. You think you're just going to get this wham, this an answer or a word or a, it's subtle sometimes, and you have to let it settle within you sometimes. And you go, oh, okay, I just heard Lyran in my head, or oh, I heard Pleiadians, or I heard angels, or I heard something else entirely. Let it sit with you for a moment and see how it feels. Does it feel comfortable? Does it resonate? Does it not? Sometimes it doesn't because of our belief systems. Sometimes we have to be aware of that. If it's our belief system that's preventing us from believing the information, sometimes we have to sit on it for a little while and just let it meld. Ask it for a little while. Sleep on it, if you will. And you'll know the answer. So, and the same goes for any questions out there when it has to do with, I've asked for a specific kind of DNA, or if I have asked for a DNA infusion of Pleiadian, did I get it? Uh-huh. Because you've asked for it. You can't, first of all, nobody can give you something that's uninvited. And let's touch on that just for a second with the languages. Same thing with the channeler. You're in charge, you're the boss, and it's all about your belief systems. And you start out, if you're concerned, start out with the languages by saying, nobody's allowed in that is not of the highest love, the highest vibration, and the highest benevolence. That's it. And it's done. Now, if you feel you need to do that every time you speak them, that's fine. But that's something that is also a permission slip, because everything's a permission slip. So if you ask yourself who's in the room, now that day when we were hanging out, had I not gone with my instincts, Omran and I probably wouldn't have had the conversation that we had, and he may not have even started to speak languages. And it was interesting because I happened that day to feel what I felt was the jinn, the jenna, the genies, the Genie Collective. So all of a sudden I'm feeling this energy, and I start to kind of see these energies around him in my, kind of in my mind's eye, but sort of, it was more in my mind's eye, not necessarily in the room, but I could feel these colorful energies around him. So I just happened to ask him something about, weren't we talking about Persia? Maybe it was Persia. And I said something about, I have, yeah, interesting, because I feel a connection to you with Persia, and something about the jinn and the jenna. Well, that opened up a whole thing. He's like, yes. So it, had I not trusted it, we wouldn't have made that connection, and we wouldn't have had that conversation, and it was a lot of fun. And we just, all of a sudden, we just slowly but surely, I said, okay, do you want to speak? And he's like, yes, but I'm afraid. I feel like it's stuck in my throat. And so we just kind of played with it. And by the end of the conversation, and it wasn't even that long, really, and we were talking in galactic languages.
Yes, that's
so
true.
Awesome. Yeah. And Wendy, Jonalee has something she'd like to share.
Oh,
that's
yes,
okay.
Please. Yeah.
Go ahead, Jonalee.
Okay, thank you. Wendy, the very first time that I came in, which is only a few months ago, and listening to various ones of you speaking in the galactic languages, first of all, thank you for relating that the galactic languages have been known by such things as speaking in tongues and all thousands of years past. But I didn't know what I was listening to. I didn't know what I was hearing. And yet after the live session, I was invited to share my language, and I'm going, you know, the only thing I know is what I consider my prayer language. And I shared it, and I got feedback that people were surprised I did so. But the main thing about sharing that is that when I did, the thought was, all creation sings. And that's exactly what Wendy is talking about now. We are all connected. We are all creation. We are all creators, and we all participate. And the thing that's enlivening to me is that, first of all, recognizing and beginning to understand that we are all connected, and that doesn't mean just those of us on Earth. That means anything that has ever been created, and including other planets, including other solar systems, including other galaxies, including other beings, as well as all creation here on Earth, from the tiniest insect to the most advanced human being to others who may be visiting us. And that's all. It's just really exciting, and I wanted to share that because it doesn't matter what you believe. It doesn't matter what path you are on. We're all on the same path, and that path is a return to and becoming a part of Creator, Source, God, whomever you choose to identify with. Thank you.
Oh, that's so beautiful, Jonalee. Oh, go ahead again, Wendy.
Yes, go ahead. I'm sorry, Val. Go ahead.
Just go ahead. I've said it. You can go take her back.
Oh, that's, you know, and you're, I love that you shared that, and I like how you had introduced it as prayer language, because that's something, actually, that's a term I hadn't really heard yet. And I like that because it kind of gives a little bit of a bridge to those who still feel it's a little, I don't know, more extraterrestrial necessarily than, which, because for some people, because of their belief systems, is not as comfortable. It's easier for some people to accept that it's God or the angels than it is beings living on other planets. And that's okay, too. It's all of the above. It's whatever you relate to, whatever is part of your journey now, whatever it is that you, as your higher selves, decided to do here in this way, in this now, in this particular timeline, how it relates to you. I've been surprised how emotional I become listening to them, the languages, speaking them. I have to be honest, there have been times when any of you who've seen any of my videos, I'm out in the farm fields, I'm in the woods, I'm on the lake. It doesn't matter where I am. It's almost as if even talking about it is very emotional sometimes, because it's almost as if everything is talking to me. And this is where we come into things like crystals, for example. Now, we all know that crystals carry energy, sound, intention, healing, you know, and we use them, they're permission slips, but they're permission slips for all of us. And the reason I bring that up is because language and light language and sound, even when you talk to your children, your pets, the earth, how many times do they tell us when you want to feel better, go out in nature, go out to the country. If you live in the city, go put your feet in the grass and go ground. Go hold a tree. That's been an age-old thing. So the languages are kind of the same thing. It's about everything talking. Everything's talking. And I feel it when I'm out there. It's as if I can hear it. And then the most validating part of it all is when you come into a hangout and you speak languages and somebody else can translate it. And then you're like, oh my gosh, I really am actually, somebody's hearing or feeling a message. Which I was ecstatic when people, Jim was translating them, Kim was translating them. It was so exciting, and it was something that I really was excited to do. So I was like, well, I want to do that too. You know, I want to be able to interpret. And well, ask and it is given. If you don't say you want it, it's not going to happen. So once you say you want that, it will happen, because that's manifestation. And that's part of galactic languages. How, okay, and this came to me too just now, is what about magic, guys? I mean, that's what magic has been all along, isn't it? People saying a saying with intention to manifest and change matter. I mean, isn't that what magic has been all along? Languages we didn't understand, or things being said in a specific way with a specific intention, and you add specific things to the pot, and then poof, manifestation. You open a gate, you open a portal. Well, that's part of what we're talking about now too with galactic languages. We have been asking now to speak to our galactic families. We have been asking to speak to our higher selves. We are raising our frequency and our consciousness. We want to know what's out there. We've been asking and asking. We want to talk to the angels. We want to open our hearts. We have all been working on healing, clearing, balancing, working on our chakras, cleaning up our diets, cleaning up our acts, cleaning up our lives, cleaning up our worlds, our relationships. We're all working on cleaning all this stuff up so we can be better beings. So we can clear the way to open the doors and the portals to allow this information in. Galactic languages is just another piece of that puzzle. It's a way for them to connect, and it is also a way to activate yourself, to be open to these higher frequencies, because they have to meet us halfway. We have to be able to raise our frequency high enough for them to come as low as they can to meet us. And that's part of what this is. And anybody who speaks them or hears them, like, you inherently feel your vibration raising. Whether or not there's a translation and interpretation at all. And I've had the experience, I still listen to other people speaking light languages on other channels, because it helps me open up my own doors. And it helps me identify other languages, because now there's a lot of people out there who say, okay, I'm speaking Sirian. So now when I watch their video and I listen to them, well, right away I'm validated that I know I've been feeling, oh, wow, I understand that language, I feel that language, and I've been told by my guides that's Sirian. And everybody else who has been speaking it here, like in our hangouts throughout the years and months, we all go, wow, that feels Sirian. Well, Wendy, now we're... I'm sorry, go ahead.
Excuse me, Wendy. Could you speak a little of that?
Oh, sure. Yeah, and I was going to say that too. Yeah,
Christina,
I wanted to
here on the side says, what is speaking in tongues? So let's show her.
Yeah, so, and that's great. Now that we're talking about languages, let's speak a little. And I was actually wanted to do that too, was I wanted to give everybody an opportunity to do that as well. So say, for example, like I want to invite my Sirian. So I just kind of ask if there's any of my Sirian family, my family from Sirius that would like to come through or speak or share their energy, I'm open to you. And it's kind of as simple as that.
Mi mayela hina kadoko ya kalahina kaya shoturu kwa yema akahinda ti inta talianda koya. Nishia nakala. Sonu haya mayawani ana asaki toha sonu borashianaki.
They're basically saying right now just intend and allow. It's not about trying, it's just about letting it flow. And even if you feel like you sound, if you feel like you sound silly or funny, just do it alone or talk to your pets or go out in nature. That's the best place, is in nature, because you can actually, it really helps.
Ni tayakula I sana kilahana toya sonokoya pahi I tokoya pala,
and even I don't always separate them, so sometimes there's different ones mixed in. But that's okay. Don't worry about that right away. Don't worry about necessarily trying to identify it right away. It kind of muddies it a little bit. And then you're trying to figure out the how, the what, the why, instead of kind of just work on letting it flow first. I always like to think about throat chakra, the color blue, to help initiate the speaking of it.
And I'd like to just add that Zach over here on the side chat says it sounds very similar to Native American tribes.
A lot
and
of people
I agree
say
with that.
That.
Yes.
And I'm glad you brought that up, because a lot of people say that. And something I'd like to add that I've been guided by my own spirit guides is, and I think that many of us already understand this, all the places across our earth have been inhabited by galactic families forever. So even our own languages that have come through on cave walls, pyramid walls have been, I mean, we're still trying to figure it all out, aren't we? We still don't really know. We're guessing. At this point, we're still guessing. So each place on the planet seems to have been inhabited by certain galactic families. Around where I live here, I happen to feel a great deal of Native American energy, because there were a lot of different Native American tribes here around the Midwest, around the Great Lakes, and I feel them. Now, I've been given visions upon visions of my lives as a shaman here, where I live now, with the Native American tribes, and there's a definite connection between, for example, the Pleiadians and the Potawatomi Indians. And this is just something that I know because I know, because they've told me, because I've seen the visions, I've seen me. I've seen me as, you know, the healer and the seer, I guess. I don't know how else to put it. So, yes, I'm glad that you mentioned that, because a lot of people say that, there's actually some languages, the galactic languages, that sound
Japanese. They sound, I mean, we've joked about that before, even Shin and I, about how when we first started speaking languages, because he speaks Lyran and Syrian, and so he and I started to be able to identify them, and some of them sound pretty like, Hanoa sotoka mashataki hamaki wa alana. Oto kashayami katayhana no kashayawaha. So no you shamika la hina kukoyama koshanakya la kotorokoa. Mohanaki. It's so it's very strong. I mean, how does that sound to you? Does that sound more Native American, or does that sound something else?
Yeah.
Can I add? Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, yeah, Shin. Hey, yeah, please.
The other day, I've been speaking, I think I'm speaking Lyran, but I'm not sure, right? And, you know, whenever I speak and whenever I hear someone speak, I can, you know, tell that person speaks similar to my language, or, you know, I heard that sound with, you know, it's similar with Wendy's whatever, right? But the other day, I was, you know, hanging out with you guys and speaking languages, and I heard Omran speak, and he sounded totally like me. To me, I mean, like personally, I think that's like exactly
it did.
What
it
I'm
was
speaking.
Weird.
So I was so surprised because
okay,
I wasn't
do me
even
a favor.
Sure.
You speak something, and I'd like Omran to answer, and I want everyone to hear it, if you don't mind.
Okay, cool.
Go ahead.
Noa tusho tikia tata no sholo shata iaka uto shunya tatia lua shura tiki shisha tati no hua tatikua tushura tina tata.
Do you want to try, Omran? He says he can't do it yet, guys. But,
no, but anyway, but I...
That's okay.
It was like confirmation for me, because it's
yes.
so similar. I mean, like, it's exactly like what I speak. So I was like, and I've never seen or talked to Omran before. That's the thing. I don't know him. I just added him to my Google Hangout today. And I have no idea who he is, but he sounded exactly like me, so I was like freaking out. Whoa, you know, so it's just I can't explain how what's going on, but
so exciting when you find another.
It is, and I'm glad that you said that too, because I had the experience a couple of weeks ago. I guess it's been a month or two anyway, a couple months now. Back in anyway, it doesn't matter. But I was at a conference, and I talked to somebody in Galactic Languages, and I really was kind of putting myself out there, but I kind of had this feeling about this person, and I started speaking languages to this person in person, and that was the first time I've ever done that, like, in person, and they spoke languages, and I was like, it was as if, and she, the way she responded, and the way, we were so shocked at each other, and we both just started speaking and speaking and speaking, and she says, and I said, I was getting that she was speaking some sort of like an insectoid, and I said, is that, and I asked her, I said, it sounds insectoid, and she says, it's cricket, and I knew it. I was like, it sounded just like, and it was, and it's like, you can't make this stuff up. I could tell immediately she was speaking to the cricket collective. I mean, how, you know, you cannot make that up. It was just like, you know.
Yeah, but, and Wendy, Shirley had a really cool story here on the side chat, and I'd like her to tell everyone just because
yes,
it does another one of those crossovers, letting people know that this is not an evil thing and that you even can learn it in a church. So Shirley, would you please tell your story?
Yes. I think I was commenting to a lady on the chat here, Christine Raposa. She was saying that, does it mean that the churches, if they practice speaking in tongues, are they in tune with ETs, or, you know, what is speaking in tongues? And so I was just telling her that originally when I was in the Pentecostal church in about 1991. I got baptized by the Holy Spirit, as they call it. And then when you get baptized by the Holy Spirit, you sort of feel it coming down upon you, but you want that gift. You want the gift of speaking in tongues. That came down forth. So that was a thing that was in the church, was the speaking of tongues, and also in the Bible or what have it, they had written there that you also had people that had the gift of interpreting tongues. So you actually had that there were people who were able to interpret it. But she was asking whether it was if it's the same, what is speaking in tongues? And I honestly asked this about a week ago, you know, is what is speaking in tongues? And so I've learned that speaking in tongues is the same as the light language, galactic language, the language of the angels. It doesn't necessarily have to be ETs. And so I put the whole thing on a back burner till now. So we're talking about 20 years. And now suddenly I find out that speaking in tongues was light language. It was speaking from your heart to God. The whole point about speaking the tongues was that when you worshipped God, you didn't have the words to express your love, your joy, and so you spoke from your heart. It was that sort of that medium, you know, that intermediary, or what, you know what I mean, to speak for you, to that language of your heart to speak to God, because you didn't have the words to do it with. And so all this time I had it and I didn't know. So, is that okay? Sorry.
Yes.
Thank you, Shirley. And I was there. I was actually, it was interesting because we were in a hangout and Shirley just happened to hop in. And I said hi and welcome. And I was like, you know, just out of curiosity, you know, how did you, you know, which link did you get to? She's like, how did you get in the hangout? I was just curious, you know, and she said, you know what? I don't even know. I just ended up here. And as we were talking about languages, she was just like, I'm so relieved to hear you talk about this, because all this time I've been wondering, but that's the key here. She asked the question a week ago in her heart, her mind. She put it out to the universe. I want to know more about this. And her guides brought her right into that hangout. Didn't they?
Yeah, it was really amazing. Yeah, it was.
I mean, it was. It was complete happenstance. But that's why everyone calls me the Queen of Synchronicity, because I love pointing out everything is synchronicity. Everything is you being in harmony with your path. So if you're here, it's because you've been guided here by your guides, because you've been asking something about this. Is there any questions right now, Val, from anybody?
Can I quickly say something?
Sure.
I just wanted to quickly say how liberating it's been, because it's quite scary. You know, you sort of feel like you're the only person who's doing this, and you might be a little bit crazy, and then I didn't understand what the whole thing has been about. It's just completely blown my world even further open, you know. So it's just so liberating to be able to be in a room with other people speaking in languages like this, and the vibration goes higher. I mean, you know what it was like the day we had that hangout. I was on a high for 2 days. I couldn't get down.
It was. You were just floating.
It was wonderful, absolutely wonderful. So I just wanted to say how liberating it was and how exciting it all is. And it's just, like I say, a key to opening up a new door, you know, like that. So anyway, that's me.
Thank you. And it is. It is. And, you know, I wanted to say something just briefly about that, too, about feeling weird about it. I have to tell you guys, it took me Wow. You know, I had a YouTube channel probably for almost a year before I even told my family that I even spoke languages. No one knew. No one. Even, and it took me up until, well, it's been almost, I've been speaking them now for a couple of years, and it took me up until last, it wasn't until last August that I even told my own partner, my own spouse. And I'm still getting comfortable with it here in my own home, and it's not something I walk around, even though I'm out there in the woods and stuff, it's not something that I'm still comfortable doing, you know, but I mean, like up and down the street in my neighborhood, but I'm getting the push to start, like, getting it out there in the world, like meetups, you know, that kind of thing, you know, starting groups there, and several of us, Johannes and I were talking about that yesterday, about some of us are starting to feel that push to share the languages, and I think that it's that push of energy for many of us from our ET friends to, you know, because it's pushing us toward first contact. That's part of the whole process. And as galactic ambassadors and those of us who like being first contact specialists and learning all these languages so that we can meet and greet other, you know, star families.
And also so we can help others to awaken.
Exactly. And it's healing. It's to bring healing to the earth. It's to bring healing to the human collective. This is not just languages. It's actual physical healing. When people listen to them, it changes them. It raises their vibration to the point where they're physically a different person. And we, as we understand what healing really is, it's not really healing a specific person or the part of their body. It's raising the person's vibration to the place of where they are feeling whole and complete and healed. That's the job of a healer. It's not, you're just a conduit. We're just conduits. We're empowering the person to find their own power within. That's part of what languages do, is they heal this, they heal us in such a way that it's almost from the inside out. It's like a healing of these multi-level layers of us that happens in a way that we are, then it allows us to actually heal others by just by virtue of us raising our own vibration, because you carry yourself differently through the world then. When you greet people in your everyday life, you carry yourself different. You act differently toward them. You treat them differently. They feel the love just exuding from you, just like you do when you come across somebody like that. Or when we come into a hangout with each other, we can feel each other's energy. It is unmistakable. So it's no different with our ET friends, our angels, our spirit guides, God. There is no limit to who you can talk to or what you can talk to. We are all connected to everything. And so if you can, I wish I had my little, anyway, so if you can picture your, you know, God, if you want, or source, the one energy as one big fireball of energy, and all of us are just little strands of light timelines coming off of that. And then, I mean, that's just a very simple analogy, but then you've got, you know, the oversoul, and then the oversouls, you know, think of a crystal that continues to grow and grow and grow and grow and grow. Well, if you hurt part of the crystal, you hurt, technically, you hurt the whole crystal. That's what it's all about. Everything affects everything. Everything. So this is what we as a human collective consciousness haven't quite grasped yet, and which is why they can't come here yet, because, well, technically, can't show themselves, because we haven't figured that out yet. We can't even figure out how to get along. So with our own colors of the rainbow, we're not there yet vibrationally, and this helps us do that. It helps us open up the portals and the doors within us. It actually changes, as Tucker once said when I asked about the what physiological changes happen with galactic languages, and it's not so much a DNA thing, not necessarily, she said, because DNA really only changes with DNA, like infusions or that sort of thing. It changes your mind and the way you think, the way you're open to new ideas, the way it changes your brain and your third eye and your pituitary gland and the way you see things, the way you understand things, the way it allows us to perceive our life in a new way, that you're able to tackle everyday little situations with your friends and your family and your coworkers and so forth in a different way than you were able to before. It allows you to sort of step back and see the bigger picture and sort of understand that you really are creating your reality by being in the now, that the now is always creating your past. I mean, the past, okay, so an hour ago we created the past, you know, we created an hour ago. So right now we're always creating our past. We're always creating our past. And by creating our past right now, we're also creating our future, obviously, because a minute ago is now is a minute ago's future. Now, I know that sounds kind of, you know, physics, but it's simple, really. So the galactic languages, too, kind of bring us into the now. They bring us into focus, into connecting with the now, because it's in the now that connects us to everything. So that's part of its beauty. So with that said, I'm just going to get a drink real quick, and then I'm going to say something, and then I wanted to see, one, if there's any other questions, and then, two, I wanted to start actually speaking languages.
That's what I was going to say. Why can't we just go ahead and start speaking and invite others to speak, and maybe Jim can do a little translating, and so we can get this party started.
I'd like to ask a question first, if I may.
Please.
Oh, great. Thank you. And thank you, Wendy. This is Stephanie. I just want to say first, I do very much appreciate your nature videos. I enjoy those. My question is, there's been times I understand that, and if you can speak to this, I'd appreciate it. If you can't, that's no problem. But there's times that I've been told it's like some language that I'm, what I came to understand, I guess, was a language, that it's downloading code. Is, can you tell me the difference between galactic languages, of which a variety have come out of me, and what is downloading code, and if and when you can tell the difference? If you can speak to that, that's fine. If not,
yes.
don't struggle.
No, absolutely. I'm, and it's a great question, because, you know, I forgot to talk about light codes, and there's a lot of information out there about light codes, and I encourage everybody to, you know, look into it if it's something that interests you, because there's a lot of information out there and probably more than we can talk about today. But the one, there's Brad Johnson, which many of you already know. He's a great channeler. He channels Adranus from Sirius and Rayar, who is Yahyel. And he does a lot of great classes. And one of the ones he does is about, he talks about light codes. I was also fortunate enough to be in one of his classes that he did a while back. He was doing them on Sundays. And I asked Adranus the question about galactic languages and light codes. And first of all, everything contains light codes. And light codes are basically information stored in light that comes through everything. Now, there's light codes in plants. There's light codes in everything, whether it's numbers, the combinations of numbers, everything that lives and breathes is sending light codes. it's information. And we realize that more and more once we realize that things are actually, like when you hook up the electrodes to the plants and you can actually hear them actually playing music. And when one hears the next one, and the next one, and the next one, as they continue to hook up the electrodes, more and more start to react and sing and dance, and it becomes this symphony. So the first part of the answer is everything has light codes. The second part of that is that it's always sending light codes. So there is no difference. The only difference is if they will sometimes tell me that these are specific light codes that we want to send out. And like sometimes they'll want me to say, sometimes they'll want me to focus on a particular color, as you know, or chakra. Like for example, one day they said to me, we want you to start this thing and call it the sound of color. And what we're going to do is we're going to send light codes, but we want you to look at things of that color. And my very, very early videos, one day I was just walking my dog in the forest, and all of a sudden I hear this telepathic voice, is the best I can come up with, and they said, you know, like, hello, we are the emissaries of the Light Collective. We are a collective of beings of all realms, of many, many realms and civilizations who have agreed to come together to share collective information. And it was kind of like a greeting kind of thing. And it was weird because I wasn't even on Google yet. I wasn't even on YouTube or anything. And I just happened to have my cell phone in my pocket, and they said, you know, we'd really like you to start videotaping nature, because there's a lot of light, and they used the word light codes, and they said, We have information from the light, various, you know, and we'd like you to bring in combination, it's almost like an alchemy, if you will. We'd like you to bring the information from nature and the light codes that are contained, and we'd like you to speak these languages along with it, because together they're very healing. And we'd like you to present it to the world in such a way that, and I wasn't even in the videos, and I was happy because I really was not comfortable with that. So I was videotaping nature, and just sort of, it was weird because a lot of times I'm actually my eyes closed, which is odd because I'm like looking at things, but my eyes are closed. So I'm hoping that, and I have to watch the video later to see what I've even recorded sometimes. So, and most of the time, half the time, I don't even remember what I said anyway. So they're telling, and I'm like, well, I don't know anything about the internet or Google or YouTube or anything. And they're like, well, you're about to learn. And it was weird. It was like by the end of the day, I had a Google page, and I said, well, what should we call it? What do you want me to call it? And they said, Languages of Lights, because everything is a language of light, everything. And they were like, this is what we want to show everybody, that it's not something you don't know how to do. It's something you're remembering, and everything does it. Everything speaks a language of light, whether it's our own written language or your native language or a galactic language or even the stuff you have in your house. Everything is a frequency emitting a form of language of light, because we're all light. We're all just energy. This is just a physical focus. This is just a very, very teeny tiny piece of who you are. This three-dimensional focus, we are, as we know now, multidimensional, endless, timeless, etheric beings focusing in this 3D experience to show all that is and everybody watching how to come from a very thick, dense place and find the light by finding love. And one of the purposes of the galactic language is to teach us how to find love, because when you're speaking languages, and even now talking about it, and I can't tell you how many times I've cried, and it's a very strange experience when you watch your own video and you're listening to yourself self-speak light languages and you're crying at your own video, because it's you're experiencing it here, not here. So, with that said, I'm just going to say something really quick, and then I'm going to have you guys jump in.
Actually, Donnelly has a question, too, when you
do. Oh, sure. Okay. Go ahead, please.
Wendy, when you were talking about our past, our now is creating our past, and our past is creating our now, how might you suggest we practice being in the now?
Practicing, and that is such a stellar question, because that is what every single channeler from Bashar to Abraham Hicks to, it doesn't matter who it was, every one of them has told us, learn to be in the now. And the best way to suggest it is to simply be aware of what you're doing when you're doing it. And this takes a lot of practice, because we like to think and do at the same time, especially now that we've got technology. It's almost as if we don't know how to do one thing at a time anymore. Aren't we always working and listening to something or doing, you know? So the best suggestion is truly to, and this sounds so cliche, but if you can practice what Bashar says and truly be aware as often as you possibly can about what is your highest joy in that moment. And even if it's, you know, going to the bathroom or going to get something to drink or walking outside or sitting down and having a moment of breath. When you're washing your hands, wash your hands. Actually be with your hands. And think about how when you're washing your hands, how if you've ever not been able, like say if you've ever hurt yourself, how you don't appreciate your hands until like it hurts or something, you know, take that moment to appreciate your fingernails and your hands and maybe your adornments that you've, you know, collected over time. Look at yourself in the mirror when you're washing your hands and be in that moment of connectedness with yourself and not planning your day, worrying about your mother, worrying about your kids. What have I got to do tomorrow? Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. We're constantly in this state of being aware of something else instead of what we're doing. And it brings you into the now, because what happens when that happens, and even if it's you're doing the dishes or you're doing the laundry or you're at work, being in that moment, you open a door that it's almost like you're opening the door to everything all at one time. And it's as if it's like allowing you access to like this big pool of all information that we're otherwise too busy to find. And the only way we can find it is in like that quiet. Because think about how many times you've been in like the restroom, and it's not called a restroom for no reason. It was because it was a place to rest. Your body, your mind, and everything. So, and sometimes don't we all have to even just go there because there's just nowhere else to be alone sometimes? In the middle of the day, you're just freaking out. That's the point. Go be in the now. And the point is that when you're in that place and you're actually paying attention to what you're doing, and you're saying, you know, I love that I have dishes to wash. I love that I can look out my window. You're in this place of gratitude, and the gratitude raises your vibration. And as it raises your vibration, you start to feel this place inside of you kind of open up just a little bit, because that's what gratitude does. That's what joy does. We know that. So now you're opening up this place inside of yourself that allows you to access information that you couldn't access before because you're not allowing yourself to be there. So as we go through our day and we allow ourselves to be in that now, like he says, and being aware that this now is creating our past and our present, it changes the way you react to things too. Because all of a sudden it allows you to kind of step back just a quick sec and say, if I react in this way that I used to react, it's going to create the same type of frequency that I used to create, that I don't want to create anymore. So it allows us to take a step back and not analyze, but realize that we have the power in that now to change a situation based on our frequency. Because then what happens is, if you really truly can kind of follow, Bashar, that we're moving through timelines, billions of timelines, moment by moment by moment, if you can really walk into that knowing, then you realize that by virtue of your frequency, you're changing your frequency to the reality of which you're now, you literally can walk out of that washroom and now you are literally greeting a new version of those people. Because you've raised your vibration, you've walked into a new timeline in which that bitchy boss is not so bitchy anymore, because you've raised your vibration to a higher vibration of all of those people. That's kind of the magic of being in the now. Does that help?
Yes, that helps. And there's a few comments on the sidebar that I want to relate to that too. And one of them is letting go. It is a form of letting go. One of the things that I've been practicing that I call staying in the present moment is that I don't plan anymore. I mean, I have a schedule of what I think I'm going to do that day. And I was getting really frustrated with situations that would crop up and my whole day would change. So I thought, the only way I can control this is by, and it's not really controlling, it's more controlling my own emotions, my own responses to things, is by saying, okay, I'm planning this. If I need to be doing something else, or if something else is of greater importance than this thing, then I allow whatever is going to be there to be. If I have an appointment with a friend and we're supposed to go to lunch and something happens where she can't go or I can't go, I used to get really upset about that, and still, you know, there's a form of disappointment, but at the same time, I'm learning that there's a reason for it, either on her end or on my end, and usually it works out that it allows something else to happen on my end too. And I go, okay, that was our intention. It didn't happen. This did, and I am great. And gratefulness is another thing that you mentioned that is, I think, is really important too. I'm grateful for this because I learned that if I had stuck to this original thing, this other thing that turns out better in the long run would have never happened. But it's still very difficult for me as a human being to know and to realize in the moment that this change is for the good of everyone at some point. Anyway, thank you for letting me share, and thank you for answering. It was so complete, and thank you everybody who shared on the side chat, because you're helping all of this idea of being in the present become more fully integrated and understood within myself. Namaste.
Thank you, Jonalee. That was very, very wonderful for you to say. And Jim, would you like to comment?
Well, unfortunately, I have somewhere to be at noon, so I have to go get ready. I didn't do much interpreting. But I'm sure there are those out there that can. But there is an event that I have to be to at noon, so I have to go get ready for that now. So, but you're doing a wonderful job, Wendy, and the information is fantastic. So I will talk to you later.
Thank you so much for being here with us today, Jim. Your presence was most appreciated.
Oh, much love to you all. Bye-bye.
Goodbye. Okay, bye-bye. Does anybody else have a story that they would like to share quickly about maybe how they came about starting to speak languages or awaken?
I can speak upon my story, if I may.
That'd be wonderful. Go right ahead.
I will just do a quick one. Yeah.
This is Johannes, by the way.
Yeah, I'm sorry. This is Johannes, by the way.
Can you quickly state your story there, Johannes?
Can you hear me?
We can now.
Yeah, okay, good. If you can hear me, that's fine. I will speak upon how I also started to introduce myself to my soul language. I like to call it soul language because it comes from within my soul and previous reincarnations and past lives and all that.
And maybe you can speak a little for us as well, Johannes?
I can. I will just tell a little bit of my story speaking this language also, because it's a very powerful language that I'm speaking. I'm speaking my father's old language, my soul father. His name is Aisha, and he is working with me pretty much lately, I have to say, because I'm also inviting it. I'm asking for it. I'm asking for it loudly, so I'm speaking to myself basically about what I want. And but I have to again thank Wendy for her work, because without her I wouldn't be starting speaking, I think. So blessings to you, Wendy, and all you all who are here also today to support this idea about speaking from the soul, from within. Yeah, I will do some language right now, I think. That's what I feel.
Shakasianahai Yawahai Rakahaiana Wahai Yasakahai Nahaya kasahaya rahaya nawahaya kasaha Nohaya wahaya sawahaya Naharaka sahaya kaniya wahai Rawahaya kasawaha nahaya Nohaya Yakaria Karia Sahaya Karia Karia Mohai Karia Karia Ria Sawaha
Yeah, that was what came today. So I think, thank Aisha for that.
Oh, nashoko ena hitahisa na into ko hempuko ya na hiva alusu uhanu toka hano ayentu wa susoha numba hanaki entusa mahosa.
Did you get an idea of or a feel for maybe what you might have been saying?
It's his language to me, as I interpret it all the time, it's inspirational. It's very, very inspirational to find your own power within, to bring it out and to speak it, to experience really the depth of the power that you are, and that you're allowed to express anything, you're allowed to to be yourself in the way you are, because you are beautiful in your specific ways. So express it and thank it, thank yourself. It's a lot of thank yous, a lot of thank yous. Kariyariya, kariyariya, kariyariya. All the time, kariyariya. Thank everything, thank yourself, thank your energy, thank the sound, thank the air, thank the whatever you can thank, thank it. And it is powerful to say thank you. It's the most powerful word.
Gratitude truly is probably the most powerful vibration we can put ourselves in to open the door to everything. And I know we've heard it a million times, but truly the gratitude has got to start here. You've got to be grateful for who you are, that you came here, that you are here, that you're forever, that this is not happening to you. It's happening by you, for you, because you've asked for these experiences. And now we're here to understand, if you don't like the contrast that you're experiencing, you can raise your vibration to where we can now learn what we need to learn faster and easier, without the drama, without the heartache, without the judgment.
Can I just add, that's an excellent point, Wendy, because you and I both have a tough upbringing. And so for those people who've maybe been, pushed down or made to feel less than as they were growing up, know that you can still raise your vibration, that no longer controls you, that the minute you know about this, you can change your world, your life. It can be completely different than you ever thought. Wendy's living proof.
So freeing.
And so am I.
Really, and guys, it is freeing. And the scariest part of the very first words I ever heard Seth say was, "You create your own reality." It scared the crap out of me, because there's a lot of responsibility that comes with that, because we've been brought up to believe that our world happens to us, that you are being fed things as punishment. And now we understand it has nothing to do with punishment, it has nothing to do with you being less or greater than. And I wanted to touch on that a minute too. Anything that we're talking to in the cosmos is equal to you. I don't care if it's an archangel. I don't care if it's God. That's what God was trying to say all along. You are created. You are the same. You are just as powerful. You're created in the image of God, because you are God, because you have the same powers. We just came here to forget that.
And that doesn't have to do with respect.
No.
That has to do with how you perceive yourself.
Correct. You are equal to every other person. We are not less, we are not more, but we are equal to all things. And when you invite a language or an entity or anything, it's, we're on equal ground here. So you have to be able to say, I'm boss here. I get to choose who comes, who talks, who doesn't, and anybody who I don't want here isn't invited to my party. It's as simple as that. Truly, it is. So there, you don't need to worry. You don't need to have fear about opening this door, because you're only opening it up to more of who you are, and that's really what it's all about. So, are there any questions right now? And if not, I'd like to start doing languages. I'm going to start. I'll just start with a quick blessing, and then Valerie, do you want people to put their names in the box for anybody who would like to go ahead and take turns speaking? What would be easier for you?
Sure, that works. Then
that works for all of you. So anybody, that way nobody's under pressure. But if you'd like to speak, I'd love to hear every language anybody's got to speak today. So, and if I can, I'll try to interpret it, or if we can get interpretations. If you guys get a feeling of what somebody else is saying,
or a color,
speak up, because you're getting information and you need to start trusting that. So if you get something, speak up or type it in the box, say, I think I heard something or I felt something. Feel free to share it, because you're going to open a door for somebody, and it's very validating both ways. So I love coffee too. Here's to Roxy. And yes, we are all facets of God expressing itself. Thank you. Absolutely. Every one of us.
Mila sisiana ki itoroko yama yewa sisaliana katoya. Mala aniana patu asasupu ko shashaya. Mi sisala aniniana katula ataniyamaka. Toma alaha. Sona tilha aliana. Polo ho susuma ki la ananti kaleana kataya kopora. Mi na iana kalaya sisana kia. Homo tua alaki tayamakalatina. Mami anayi walaki kaya tokuiki anakawa tila sanaka. Honuwa, tila kiti alahi amawahi alasasana. Mitia, ati kekia na kalakoturku ya palandikia kai kaya masha shahi la kekia. Masum. Pliate liantara palandari ya kalatulu apaali atora hielani alma alakoturu palana. Liatala. Tola, tola, tola. Milani anana ya koya bushisha ya la ki taraki antara ko sa palati. Ti interior asasa palonta ina yo sopa ya tu ko ya na. I ana no ayishisha ya to ko ya so so ampu ko ya ta ya na usha ya na. I inta o ya na I so sopa ya na. Si ba ya na yo ayishisha ya wa ya sa sa ya wa ko ha ma yumaniana atula siana. Hokoya ba ala ki kiataki sina tiela kaha, poturuku yamba kiesha yela yendoku ya la yena hiwa. Mahala niana hiwa tu, ala nahi, anahala sanahi, noyola sinahala nahatu, ashiha. No la yana palu asina yahi, no hunahi. Mina iya waha so koko ya nama ito ko aishaka. Muha tu nahi sata ingo ashana pawa, moka ashana ku. Bonta niyana katoka, shiyama hiwa yuhu asha. Hona. Ituka. Manua saka. Etohaya. Mohan ma iwa hatuko ashashahimba kuhanaki. Intaha. Nina yuma etu kuhemba lahisi. Nina yela katuriyoka sasali yanakawa asua sina.
They wanted me to remind everybody too that this is the way that we communicate with our galactic children, our hyper children.
Inalia sasamiana koala isisiana kai sunukula sisiana tiha asa.
Often they will introduce themselves through light language.
Nina ila katuri asasala anina aso.
Plus, we also communicate to them with our sign, our hands.
Mina elakato yusokolahina na ato. Misai tari kisani la hana katati asasahima otoro kolanti arakale asasana otu nini anakata ashisho. Ina sitari kala isitara insono kusupula mishayawa mika.
Can someone mute? I'm not sure where that's coming from. Mikaya. Thank you.
Ina dukuya. Misoru koya la yena ki awala koya koya ena ki patukwa. Misa ina ki hi la sisani tarakiha. Mama ala ataraki sa la koto koya mayo la yena ka. Misa tira sono kula. Misa ina ki.
And yes, we'd like now to invite anybody who wishes to speak or converse
First, Wendy, we have a few that are asking what language. Do you know?
That was actually several. This is Syrian. Mila untaya o kahina itula makaya. Siniki kia talihina. There's also Pleiadian. Pleiano aliate ilahina ki itiki kiata ilahibalana havaukua. Pleiahiena kila kita leyandara. Pleantologulan baleana kila kita rikilandara koa polasa. There was some. I can do Arcturian, but it's a little harder for me because it's kind of really high pitched and really fast. There was also Lyran in there earlier. That's like Shin's kind of main fun. It's like his favorite language. And people will resonate with different ones, and that's to kind of show you kind of like who your main oversoul family is. So if you resonate with, you know, a particular one.
And so, like, the more languages you speak, then, the bigger your family is. Is that
exactly
correct?
Exactly. And you're just, and the more you speak, the more you invite them, and the more exciting they become. See, and the thing is that we have to remember is that they're just as excited as we are. So they're just as excited to connect. So a lot of them are like really happy and, you know, and sometimes when the kids come in, they're really excited. So, but yes, anybody who wants to speak, please feel free or if there's any questions.
I didn't really get a list of people that wanted to start, so.
Well, that's okay.
Somebody
anybody
want to
hop in?
Shy.
Yeah, don't be shy, Shin. Shirley, Johannes, anybody.
I'm sorry. Can I talk? I'm just wondering.
Please.
I don't know. I've been waking for like past year or something. I never was a religious, even the people around me trying to force me to any type of religion, but I always knew there was something bigger I need to catch on. There was something more bigger, like a higher self or something, and I didn't know such a thing that time. And I came from originally from Iran, the war and all that, so we left different countries, travel, and then all the way to Australia, and we end up buying farm, and I feel I was like a light worker. I need to do something in Australia to make more people like vibration more higher in a way. So, and then recently I feel like a Sirian race is more connected to me somehow. I don't know how, but it just feels more better when you're speaking the language. You feel really connect to my heart, and it just wants to just come out and cry just with the happiness. So, yeah, really, it felt good. So, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing that. I really appreciate it, and welcome today. I'm very happy to see, you know, new faces here and talking and sharing this information. Would you like to share some of your language? Would you care to speak some of it?
Right now, I don't know how, but it just, when I hear it, feels really good.
Oh, okay, good, good. Misa liana atokoya patari kasanika konama. Asono ko po shoto ko la anakipa atoko ko kasama li tiki si samaliana atoko shomo sasola ataki anukoto ko shashai pika liana ka palisa sani kikua sonotula nokosoa mia. Something I wanted to they wanted me to reiterate too is that you know, to speak the languages to everything around you, whenever you can, as far as,
because it's healing for yourself too, it's healing for the entire collective consciousness, it's healing to the earth, it's healing to everything. So even if you're alone, whether it's telepathically, because remember, many dimensions speak only telepathically. They don't even speak galactic languages. So a lot of times you're going to hear it comes in a telepathic message too. So, but the point is that if we can share the languages either in your heart space, your mind, or verbally, it heals everything and it changes it, the ripples that get sent out. It's like music or television or radio waves. It never ends. It just is out there forever. And so if you can remember that, it heals, and so it heals everything. So you can speak languages to your water, your food, the land, your neighborhood, your community. Raise yourself up and picture yourself speaking to your country, the earth, the cosmos. I mean, if you can raise yourself up to the idea of realizing that what you're doing affects everything, and I mean everything, every planet, every race, every civilization, anybody who's out there in that frequency can hear you. That's and true. They're waving back.
That's the beauty of it. Yeah, thank you for your time.
It's my highest joy, and that's the thing. And I'm really busy in my 3D life now, but I plan on doing more and more of this and helping people one-on-one if that's what they want. But the idea is to get out there and just share it, do it with yourself, get hangouts together. If you feel more comfortable with, your own little circles. But the point is to do it. It's healing for everyone. It's healing for you. It's about following your joy, and it really does help bring you back to center. It brings you back to a place of gratitude. And it's the other way around, too. Being in the place of center and being in gratitude also opens the door to the languages. So it goes both ways.
Okay, Wendy?
Mm-hmm.
We have Zach here that would like to ask a question.
Oh, sure, go ahead. Hi, Zach.
Wendy? You mentioned telepathic communication. Can you give me an example of what that feels like? How does that present itself to you?
You know, sometimes it presents itself, it's so subtle, sometimes you think, okay, is that my head, am I making it up? And the one thing I'm being constantly reminded, actually telepathically, telepathic is nothing more than an idea that comes to your mind. It's kind of like when Einstein would try to solve a problem, and he understood frequency. So he understood the question was not the same frequency as the answer. So therefore, he would go to sleep. He would say, okay, I'm going to intend that I would like to solve this problem or this equation, and I'm going to go take a nap. And when I wake up, I'm going to have the answer. And so he would either receive it in a dream state or many inventors this happens to in similar fashion, or they would wake up, and it was like it would come to them just in an idea. Have you ever woken up one day and had an idea for an invention, and then you realize a couple days later that you've moved into a new timeline in which it's already been invented, or that you really wanted something and then you realize it wasn't there before and now it is? So it comes to us in like this very subtle, it's almost like an idea or a thought. And then you think, but you have to understand, it's one big pool of thoughts. There is no original thought, really. We're all kind of just swimming in a big, fishbowl of every thought that's ever been thought kind of thing. And so a lot of times they'll come as a thought, or they come as like a message in a song. Like all of a sudden you'll be thinking, like say you ask a question to your guides or something, and all of a sudden you turn on the radio and a song comes on and you're like, oh my God, that's the answer to my question. Because they have to come through to us in the only way that they can, and sometimes, you know, it's through our 3D reality. So sometimes it'll be a song, a TV show, a billboard. Sometimes I look down on the ground when I'm walking out in the forest and I see something on the ground and it's like I get an answer. Or I'll see a shape of the branches. Like everybody knows how much I love the sacred geometry in the forest, because it's all a language, and they tell me like telepathically, like, zoom in on these branches because it's a shape or it's a symbol or it's a... So they come in a variety of ways. So telepathically can be a thought, an image. That's why they call it like clairaudient, clairvoyant, clairsentient. Sometimes it comes as a feeling. Sometimes it's a thought.
Faces?
Yes, faces. You'll get faces, names. I've been writing names in my journals, for example, for years, and all of a sudden... It's like I hear the name again. It's like I'll meet somebody in like our group that had that name. But what I realize is I'll be writing down, or automatic writing. One of the best things to do is automatic writing when you're just writing what comes to you. You're not really thinking what you want to write. A lot of names, star families. You can even ask, what star family am I closest related to? Close your eyes, and even if the answer doesn't... The best thing to do is take exactly what comes to you right in that second. Don't second guess it. Don't analyze it. Write down the first thing you get. That's always going to be your first instinct, is going to be right on the money. This is the point. We have to trust knowing the answer's here. And I can tell you and validate for you all day long, it's Pleiadian or Lyran or Sirian, but it's that inner knowing that when you hear it, it's an identify, you just like you identify with it. So does that answer your question? Or
yes, it does.
No, have you had that experience?
Yes. Yes, I have.
Is it more subtle than you think, and so you question it?
Yeah, it's so very subtle that it's,
yes.
You know,
this is why we ignore it.
Distinguish. Yeah.
Because we can't trust it, because it's our belief system sometimes, and this is part of what the light language does. It helps us break down our belief systems that have been preventing us from connecting to ourself, our higher self, the idea that we have the power to do whatever we say, following I am, following I want, I believe. That's why our words, somebody said that in the chat earlier today, I noticed, about the power and the vibration of your words and saying it out loud. There's a lot more power in saying something out loud, which is why I was guided, for many of you that know, I heard one day Bashar in a video, he was talking about doing a self-love kind of thing, and so I got this idea to start this 49-day self-love challenge, and all it is spending like a couple seconds in the morning and a couple seconds in the evening, and all you're doing is saying specific things in a specific order, looking at yourself in the mirror. We have such a hard time. You know how many people cringed when I told them the exercise included looking at yourself in the mirror? Everyone's like, ew, I don't want to do that. Why? Because you're going to find out who you are? What are we so afraid of? So this helps break down the fear of even finding out who we are. That's part of what the languages do. It helps us break down the fear of who we are, of the beliefs that don't belong to us, the beliefs that don't serve us, the beliefs that are preventing us from understanding the power and the gods and the goddesses that we are, that we have the power to manifest anything we want, that we have the power to heal through our hands, that we have the power to heal in our intentions, that we have the power to say, if I drink this coffee and I fill it with love and blessings, and that everything, or I love the one where I walk into a grocery store and I speak galactic languages, either really, really quiet, or I speak it to all the food on all the shelves and all the people in the grocery store and everywhere I go, and I just tell every, I just send my love and blessings, and I say to them, whoever needs any kind of healing, I bless you that your belief systems will bring you to a place where you find your own love, your own guidance, your own power, that you find harmony in your life and your relationships, that you discover the beauty of your gifts and your abilities and the courage to share them with the world, because that's why we came. Mm-hmm. If you can begin to understand the power that that has, and you will reap, you're going to start to see immediately the reflection of that coming back to you, and you're going to get validated over and over and over that healing went out and it comes back to you, because we all are permission slips to each other. We're all each other's mirror. We're all a reflection. It doesn't matter who you are and who you're with. That's your soulmate in that now.
That's what they mean by we are all one. Exactly. Thank you. We have
Wendy, that was another... great. Thank you very much.
Very good.
I hope that answered your question.
Yes. We're getting down on time.
Sure.
A little bit. We're going to go off live, but we can still, you know, you can still chat after
does
that.
Does anybody want to do a galactic blessing with me?
We have someone first, Wendy, yes. Who is new and who would love to speak, and her name is Manila. So this is her first time unmuting and everything, so be just a little patient, and we hope she has this all figured out. Manila, go ahead. Did you find the button up top and click the microphone? Oh, I think that would be your video that you clicked instead of the microphone. Yep, just over to the left there, the next button over, and that should get you to the microphone. Well, that's too bad.
Can you unmute her, Val? You might be able to unmute her.
Let me see.
Thank you, Emma. Yeah. You might be able to for her.
No problemo.
No, I can't. I don't have that. I didn't get that control today.
Oh.
Is anybody else?
I forgot.
I think she's talking now.
Hi.
Can everyone hear me?
Yes. Hi. Welcome. I'm so happy you're here. Would you like to speak?
I'm clear.
Yes, very.
Yes,
thank
you. Yes, I'm so excited to be here.
Yay!
Thank you for allowing me to speak. I replied to one of your videos before, Wendy, on YouTube.
Oh, you did? Oh, great.
I can't believe I'm here. Yes. Yes, so, okay. I will just speak real quick, so I'll be brief.
Sure.
I don't really know what origin it stems from, but it just comes so naturally to me. I have songs, and I just speak to my environment, to within, so... Sometimes I'll speak and I want to go in a song, so I'm just going to let it flow. I'm really nervous. Okay. Itriya shantriya sala akununutinia shantriya sala nikawara itora na shanti awarini shantriya sala akono shantriya ma akania undriya shalaniya sala nikini tonan shantriya sala ikona matini intriya salania turiya shantini tura matene shalani salani tuarekene no shantriya patania Inatriya swaniantariya imiya unai sunainai sundriya shwantriya niya Sorry, I got a little nervous, so I stopped.
Oh my gosh. That was so beautiful, and I recognized it immediately, and I was getting...
You did. That's so exciting.
I was getting images right away. They said, you said, greetings from, I swear you said, greetings from Era. We are the Pleiadians from Era and Maya. We are here to greet you. We are very excited with this gathering, and I'm very, and you said something like, I'm very nervous, but I'm excited to be connecting with you. Immediately, I got Era. Yatukula ania sataya mahi. Siti kilanda palatoru kia pakina. Sina yesusala. Hinayala honayahi. Our songs are very similar.
Wow.
Isali sana. Sotoko ya paina ki o sotoko hayina. Siki itiki kiana yiwala koha. Sunukuya pihariana ki kaya toroa. I'm pretty sure, yeah, we're going to have to talk.
That's so amazing.
Yeah, because I think that you're telling me, too, that you work, do you have any connection to the Galactic Children?
I'm the one that contacted you through one of your videos a long time ago, and I'm really alone on this journey. The only people that I resonate with are everyone online, such as you guys, and I'm supposed to be working.
That's normal.
And I just was like, you know what? I'm just going to see if my phone works and tune into the galactic Yay! Languages. And so that's how I'm even here. And I definitely feel a connection, and my son is very – there's something about him that I just know.
How old is he? I remember talking to you about him.
Can I ask, where are you from?
Yeah, where are you?
I live in the Sand Hills in Nebraska in a very small town.
How wonderful that you're able to connect.
Yes!
Isn't that just the best thing?
I am too, because I'm just about to explode because I know that there's so many like me and I just feel very alone, and I've spoken my language before to my mom and around my son, but he just, like, you know, he's so little and he just thinks it's normal, and other people have heard it. They'll be like, what is that? Like, my other half.
Oh, that's why I was getting children, because they were telling me to, and this I want to spread out to everybody else too, that there's people waking up who are parents out there, so just rest assured, there's parents out there waking up that their children are waking up speaking galactic light languages, and they don't know what to do because they're confused. So understand that the kids are higher vibrational. These are our indigo children, our crystal children. So I encourage you to speak to your son in galactic languages. We actually have a lot of our members whose children speak languages, a lot of them. I mean, from little tiny kids to teenagers. So they're just waking up one day. So they're kind of like teaching us, too. So they wanted me to reiterate to you, too, and that's why he thinks it's normal, because for him it is normal. So you'll forge a completely new vibrational relationship with your children if you begin to share your light languages with them. And they will become fluent in it with you. It's really fun to see these parents in our groups interacting with speaking languages with their children.
And that's kind of what happened to me. I remember as a child I would just play and talk to myself all the time. And I was trying to really remember myself as a child as, like, my spiritual growth and expanding. And then one day I was at the park with him, and we were just seeing, like, double rainbows in the sky all in this moment of a few days. And then, like, it just hit me one day, like, me being a child playing. And then I just remembered, and I just started speaking it to him. I said to him, where is this coming from? I have no idea. And ever since then, and it's been probably almost a year, I just can't stop singing it by myself, or any moment I can. I'm just always speaking it because it just feels so healing.
Yes, thank you. I'm so happy you came and that you shared that. And
I'm so glad too.
I mean, you really just kind of wrapped up the whole thing, didn't she? I mean,
I'm so excited.
That's what this is all about. Yes. I mean,
connecting and knowing you're not alone, and
yes.
sharing with one another. And now you know how to work this thing. You can participate.
You can find me. You know where to find me. You know where to find all of us now. I'm so excited. Thank you for your blessing and your introduction.
Thank you. So excited. This is like, it just solidifies that I'm not alone, and it just makes me feel so excited to be part of this. Like, it feels really good.
You just found your family.
Thank you, yes. And that's why, you guys, and that's why even in our own languages, regardless of where we live in the world, our languages break down into the words and familiar means family. Because so if it feels familiar to you, if it sounds familiar to you, it's your family answering your call. So with that said, if there's anybody else who would like to do a brief blessing, and I will close with a blessing. I know we want to probably wrap it up.
We're out of time online, and we have an appointment coming up too. So
okay.
Let's do our closing blessing then.
Okay.
And next week, remember, Jim is back.
Okay, and all of you can find me, as if you don't know, I'm Wendy from Languages of Lights. I'm on Google+ as Wendy Wolf as well. That's me. But I'm on Languages of Lights. You can find me on Facebook. I just really post my stuff on Facebook here and there. I'm Harmony Synchronicity on Facebook, and I have my Languages of Lights page on there as well. And I really share a lot of all of this stuff, not just my Languages of Lights, but everything that's passionate to me about all of this. So just so you know where you can find me if anyone is interested in light languages. And pretty soon I think I'm going to start, once I get my 3D life together here, I'm going to start doing more light language hangouts for everybody to enjoy and be a part of and do private sessions and things like that. So it's all coming down the pike. I'm just reorganizing my life. So.
Oh, that's wonderful. So make sure you check out YouTube if you want to hear more of her beautiful light languages and her singing. It is absolutely wonderful. I don't miss a single
one. Oh, you're so sweet. Thank you. I love you for saying that. And thank you, Manila, for finding me on YouTube. And thank you all for being here today. I'm so excited. We exceeded our 10 hangout today. So that was way exciting.
Yes. It's so, been beautiful having all of you here and all of you watching.
And I encourage everybody out there, look up Galactic Light Languages out there on YouTube and see who else is out there doing them and find what resonates with you and let it open up your doors, you know, let it open open up your portal. So.
Okay, we better do our closing blessing.
Yaso tuya, ishina ilakatoria palana atoya, mina itali itaya, naso. Nilia na keikiala aturukosa maliana kayu ushoya kalahana sotrua. Mina ila asa tiki ila inanya iki. Soturukosa samayana atu alayina. Mala inaki kishashashiana ki tayikoshunoa maiwa alia. Sotukulayana kisisanyana turukosa paliana. Moha tuku usunua shakita yemaki awashuna. Otuku wa sasami ya naki. Inaia sasati la karoya sasama aloha. Mitiki ati ke ashisha. Inaia lahi. Noia laha noa sotuahana. Shiaki itoyo sosomo sosoa. Speak your joy. Speak your heart. Feel it resonate within you. Feel it bubble up within you. Feel it. Feel the joy emerge from your throat chakra. Ask for your galactic families to join you. Ask them to be with you. They're always with you, but ask yourself, your higher self, to show you, to validate within you the trust. Naluko sanati. Koyomula sasanikia, sonotula sasana. Trust what you hear, trust what you know inside. Tola kisa siena kalahana. Totukoyala kima yiwadokoya salayana kataya. Toloko sasani kila asasana talakesina kalai sasana kayu shonoana itula. Kolakiena kisa. You are all very, very powerful beings, capable of anything your hearts desire. Anokoya sasana ailakayesa. Nosa, it is intention, self-acceptance, self-love, without judgment, without expectation,
and follow in your joy as far as you can take it. Naika satalayasa todokoya alana, be in the now. Being in the here and the now creates your past, creates your present, creates your future. Nisati hilasasa, and opens the door to all knowledge. Todokasana isa nikaisisa, all have access. All have access. Nosotori kashashami ilasasani, the veil is the belief, and the belief is the veil. Tanakila asasana shoshane kiela asati maniana kiasa. Torokosaniana, may you all go in the harmony of following your synchronicities and knowing the joy has brought you there, that there are no accidents, that are all you all are reflections of your soulmate, in that now all have a message for you. Greet them with love and kindness, without judgment, for they are you, bringing you a message from your higher self. Mitaya sanakila atanasi hilasana. May you be in joy and harmony, and be blessed, and open all the doors of your brilliance. Open all the doors of who you are. Makasha shani kiasa. There is nothing to fear, but knowing more of who you are. You will only find you there. And unconditional love. Mikeshana. We are one.
Namaste.
Mahalo, everyone. The light within you illuminates the light within me.
Thank you for watching, everyone. And have a wonderful weekend. We'll see you again next week.
Yes, so with that, we are going to go off air. And those who want to hang out and chat afterwards, you're welcome to stay. And I want to thank everybody who will tune in later and watch, as well as everybody who has been here today. It was nice to have a larger group. Thank you all for coming, and I look forward to seeing you in more webinars.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Val. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Jim.
Yes, everyone. Have a great day. Goodbye.
Okay. Bye-bye, all.